Strap your ass to your seat. This is Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
If you smell what the rock is cooking, well, it's the big show.
I'm a nice man.
Big snore!
Hey, Spot!
1, 2, is this on? Yo, Jimmy, hit me with that Triple H.
Is the WWF ready for a federation without Mick Foley?
Now who wants to leave the WCW?
What beautiful woman of wrestling gets naked this week?
Has the WCW become the seniors tour? Hulk, Ric Flair, someone please get them a box of Depends.
Besides the people maybe at Metamucil or Effordent, do you think anybody really cares about those two?
Yeah, we've got Vince McMahon on line one, I think, and WWF superstar Mick Foley on line two. Get ready for this week's edition of Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
Piledriver.
Hey, this is Razz, and we're coming to you from the entertainment and wrestling capital of the world in the heart of Times Square, New York City. And with me is the Kodiak Bear, professional wrestler and ballet dancer.
Hey, Razz, at least I get paid to wear tights. Can you explain why you were in a leather teddy and high-heeled boots outside the Lincoln Tunnel? That's right, it's the Kodiak Bear, professional wrestler and 351 pounds of pure sexual energy, and welcome to Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
And this is Freak. Piledriver is the only place on the radio to get your weekly dose of all the dirt, news, and mayhem in the world of wrestling.
And lots of kick-ass rock music from Metallica, Creed, Godsmack, and more. 351 pounds of pure sexual energy, please, Kodiak. I think you've been body slammed one time too many.
Raz, you know if my ass gets off this chair, I'm gonna hurt you.
All right, enough out of you, killer. Freak, what's the deal with Vince?
He's not talking to us.
Will Vince McMahon ever take our call?
Vince? Vince who? Who cares about Vince? When we've got chicks, babes, hoes, ladies, bimbos, kinda sounds like Freak's family reunion.
Hey, Kodiak, wipe the jewel from your mouth.
Can I finish, please?
Maybe I should finish.
Oh, now that's what I'm talking about.
Kodiak, put your tongue back in your mouth. I'm Roxy. Join me in my ring later on. I'll be on the ropes and waiting to tell you what's going on with the beautiful women of wrestling. This week, I'll profile the beautiful Kimberly Page of the WCW. Freak, try to stay calm. Then, I'll tell you how you can become a hoe. That's right, one of Godfather's finest. Raz, what are you doing with your hands?
My leg is itchy. We'll count down the top five bone-crushing rock tunes of the week, plus one of our listeners gives us their body slam song. Freak?
You know, I always wondered, how do you become a hoe?
I don't know, call grandma.
Hey, leave my grandma alone.
Why, nobody else has.
get off my grandma!
That's what she said.
Right, all right, enough grandma. I'll give you a review of Acclaim's bloodiest, nastiest, most ass-kicking video game ever, ECW's Hardcore Revolution, on this week's Cool Crowd.
So let's ring that bell and let the mayhem begin. And if you're not down with that, they've got two words for you.
Suck it!
This is Metallica on Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
Bone Crusher number 5.
Metallica with No Leaf Clover, our number 5 Bone Crusher of the Week. That tune makes me want to body slam someone.
Rad, you better take your Prozac.
Piledriver.
Let's check in with Al Isaacs of ScoopedWrestling.com to find out what's going on with The Rock, Triple H, and the rest of those psychos.
The WWF Report.
This is Al Isaacs from ScoopedWrestling.com with your WWF Report. For the first time since the likes of Bret Hart and Kurt Hennig graced their roster, the WWF is preparing to put on a WrestleMania where the emphasis is on wrestling. The Fed has long relied on the entertainment aspect of sports entertainment, but now with the likes of Chris Benoit, Dean Malenko, and Kurt Angle in the fold, they have some of their best legitimate grapplers of any American-based company. While not a grappler per se, Billy Gunn has been long touted as one of the best conditioned athletes in the organization. His win at last year's King of the Ring tournament didn't set his singles career on fire the way that it did for previous winners, but that all could change with his breaking away from DX in the past couple of weeks. Unfortunately, it will be some time before we see what happens. A torn rotator cuff suffered during a bout against Rikishi will sideline Mr. Ass for another 10 weeks. No WrestleMania for the Ass Man this year. I'm Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com.
I'm so jacked up, my head's ready to explode.
Kodiak, have you ever wrestled in a steel cage match?
You bet your ass I have. Why?
I just wanted to see how tough you are.
I'm so tough, I use sandpaper instead of toilet paper.
You should use a bulldozer. Now let's get into Piledriver Steel Cage Match of the Week, where you jabronis vote on which song gets slammed and what comes back to fight next week.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's bust some heads open. It's time for this week's Steel Cage Match.
Our first contender, hailing from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at a combined weight of 650 pounds, sounds like Kodiak's prom date, Cold Chamber with Tyler's song.
This week's contender.
Cold Chamber, this week's first contender. Our next contender on Piledriver's Steel Cage Match hails from St. Louis, Missouri. Coming in at 500 pounds, kind of sounds like my lunch, this is Stir with New Beginning.
This week's second contender.
Now is your chance to play Vince McMahon and decide who wins the match. Email us what song you want to stay and keep fighting next week and which song you want tossed from the cage. Our email address is piledriver@mji.com. Cold Chamber's Tyler song or Stir with New Beginning. So your ass better email us now.
That's at piledriver@mji.com. After the intermission, we get on the ropes with our girl, Roxy, as she tells us what the women of wrestling are doing. And our number four, Bone Crusher Tune of the Week.
Hello, this is Mick Foley of the WWF. You may know me as Mankind. You may know me as Cactus Jack. Please don't say you know me as Dude Love. Anyway, I am this week's featured guest on
Piledriver. You're listening to Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
Now it's time for the Young and the Wrestlers with Roxy, as she tells us who's hot and who's not with the sweet young things of wrestling. Kodiak, pull your pants up.
Raz, you know if I let this go, you're gonna get the beating.
Let's get on the ropes with Roxy for this week's The Young and the Wrestlers.
Hi, my little wrestling sweeties. I'm Roxy on the ropes, and this is my ring. And welcome to this week's The Young and the Wrestlers. First, Mae Young showed us her 78-year-old droopy boobs. Next, we find out she's pregnant with sexual chocolate Mark Henry's baby. Then we have to see her running around in edible panties. Now we find out it wasn't a baby. There was a hand stuck up there. Does the WWF want us to throw up every week? Please, enough of this granny crap. Can we see someone under 30 take off her top? Raz, get your wrist ready. Your favorite woman in wrestling is coming. March is China's month. First, she poses for a steamy pictorial in this month's Raw magazine. And muscles or not, she is smoking. Roxy has seen a preview of the WWF's Ninth Wonder of the World, where she appears in a towel and in some shots, not even that much. I think Roxy needs a towel after seeing these pictures, and Roxy never sweats. Then, on March 14th, she appears in an episode of Third Rock from the Sun. And finally, on March 19th, she's on Pacific Blue on USA Network. Raz, I think you might need both wrists. Start stretching. Well, my sweeties, I'll be back next hour with some juicy tidbits on WCW Diamond Dallas Page's valet and wife, the red-hot Kimberly Page, and how to become one of Godfather's hoes. It's easy, I'll tell you. Until next hour, this is Roxy, and I'll be on the ropes.
Thanks, Roxy. We'll check in with you next hour. Here's Creed with What If.
Bone Crusher number four.
Creed with our number four Bone Crusher of the Week.
Go ahead. 1, 2, 3. Count that man
up. Piledriver.
You think you know me? I'm wondering if you think you know me.
Now let's check in with those who are crawling, rumor mongers, yes, the Razz family.
It's time for the Ring Rats.
Hi, this is Shannon Rose from ProWrestlingDaily.com with a little indie spotlight. I'm going to talk a little about IPW Hardcore Wrestling and also the Super 8 that recently happened with ECWA Jim Kettner's promotion. Well, I tell you what, with IPW Hardcore Wrestling, they have a website, IPW-Hardcore.com. I hear many other superstars are being signed to be brought into the promotion, and Ron Nemi, the owner, is one of the top owners bringing in top talent. Also, with the ECWA, a lot of guys are in there right now. We have Kevin Kelly is in there from WWF. They recently had the Super 8 tournament a couple weeks ago, and the Fallen Angel actually defeated one of the IPW's own, Scoot Andrews, to win the tournament. And I hear the Fallen Angel may be joining WWF here soon. What is going on here? All these indies guys going everywhere.
This is Rich and KC from richandkc.com. News this week, two more possible attempts at defection in WCW. Chris Kanyon and Buff Bagwell are both making noises about leaving the company. Chris Kanyon has already approached Bill Bush about getting his release, but it was denied. He has said that he will contemplate legal action to get out of his contract. Chris has gone on record saying that he doesn't really necessarily care if he gets to the WWF or ECW, but is even willing to leave the business to get away from the mess that is now WCW. Buff Bagwell has issued an ultimatum stating that unless he gets a contract change to $1 million a year salary, he's going to leave the WCW. Now, when you consider the fact that he's already locked into a multi-year contract, I'm not real sure how he plans on doing that.
Hi, this is Nick from top-rope.com, here to give you a little bit of info on Justin Incredible from the ECW. It's just been confirmed that Shawn Michaels' TWA school has him booked on March 21st to appear in a show called Incredible Showdown, which is going to be the first major show of the independent Fed's career. So hopefully that goes well. As far as Shawn Michaels' return to the WWF, so far nothing's been heard and no dates have been made.
Man, they sound like weasels. When we come back from intermission, we'll check in with Freak, our man on the streets, as he gives us a review of ECW's new video game, and we'll tell you what song pumps up WCW superstar Diamond Dallas Page before a match.
And later in the show, Freak talks to the former WWF superstar Mick Foley in our feature interview of the week. Can some moron please tell me why Freak gets to do all the cool things?
You really need a large glass of shut up juice.
This is Y2J Chris Jericho of the World Wrestling Federation, and you're listening to the Moron Razz and the Piledriver Rock and Wrestling Radio Show, baby.
Piledriver. You're listening to Piledriver, the Rock and Wrestling Radio Show.
This week, Freak finally got out of his parents' basement and spent some time at Acclaim Entertainment and gives us a review of ECW's new video game, Hardcore Revolution.
Cause you're a freak with a microphone.
Finally, Freak has come back to Piledriver.
Drop dead.
I feel a lot of love. Thanks, Kodiak. For this week's cool crap, I checked out ECW's Hardcore Revolution for all systems. Acclaim Entertainment invited me out to play the game and see how they created it. Video Geeks Jason, Darren, and Jay from Acclaim showed me the game, which is in stores now. I asked them how hard it was to design a game like this.
Well, you know, getting everybody in and out of here, I don't know how. When we do this, we have to rely on all the talent to come in, so logistically it's pretty tough, but we work with good talent and a good company, and I have a lot of great support here. So, you know, I wouldn't say it was tough, just long.
Given the M rating, I asked the guys if it was the most violent game they've ever created.
It definitely is the most violent game Acclaim has ever done, that's for sure.
I would say it's nothing you wouldn't see on their television show. You know, or if you went to a live event, I mean, I think we've mirrored it very well in what ECW is, and I think the name fits right, ECW Hardcore Revolution. I think, you know, it's a time that they fight back and show, you know, show what WWF and WCW kind of stole and watered down a little. You know, here's what you really want to see.
It was time to put up or shut up. It was Freak versus the Video Geeks.
Go Geeks!
They chose Supernova as their wrestler. I chose Dawn Marie.
Figures.
Because I wanted to check out how realistic she looked.
Yeah.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're a sissy.
All right, Freak, I'll hold that for you. Grab a controller. Tell Darren, let's start seeing you play so we can whip you up a little.
All right, I'm going to kick Darren's ass.
There you go.
All
right.
Yeah.
You're not a rookie no more.
So what do you think so far, Freak? Let's get your comments on what you think of the game so far.
I think it's the most realistic wrestling game I've ever seen in my life. Hey, somebody just called me a bitch in the audience. I got to kick somebody's ass.
You're done.
I am over. I am pinned. I got to tell you, to be honest with you, I was looking at Nova's ass. It's so realistic that it distracted me. I'm Nova's ass. Dawn Marie's ass. I think we'll edit that part out.
The game is unbelievably realistic. It's almost as if you're watching them on TV. My favorite part of the game has to be the barbed wire match, the first of its kind, where the wrestlers actually bleed. And when you start to suck,
which you do,
the fans yell things at you. This game will set the standard for future wrestling and fighting games, I promise. This is no effing Pac-Man, as my good friend Rob Van Dam would say. I want to thank the guys over at Acclaim for showing me the game, which is in stores now and flying off the shelves. The price of the game ranges from $39.95 to $49.95, depending on what game system you're using. And Raz, you know I was looking at Dawn Marie's ass.
Sure you were looking at Dawn Marie's ass.
You know what I'm looking at?
What?
You two asses. Now here's DDP of the WCW telling us what song pumps him up before a match.
You love me. You hate me. You'll never forget me. Get ready to feel the... Self-high-five.
Hardcore tune-up of the week.
Yo, Monkey Boy, DDP here, Diamond Dallas Page from World Championship Wrestling, and my hardcore tune-up for the week is Dracula by Rob Zombie. Crank it up, Monkey Boy.
It's pronounced Dracula, Monkey Boy. Rob Zombie in our hardcore tune-up of the week.
After our next intermission, we unmask Test, that punk from the WWF, and our number three, Bone Crusher Song of the Week.
This is Mike Awesome, the ECW Heavyweight Champion, and you're listening to Piledriver, the Rockin' Wrestling Radio Show.
Piledriver. You're listening to Piledriver, the Rockin' Wrestling Radio Show.
We're back, and now let's find out what's the real deal with your favorite wrestlers. We call it Unmasked, and this week we take a look at WWF Pretty Boy Test. Kodiak, you ready?
I'm ready to rip his heart out.
Let's get unmasked.
His real name, Andrew Martin.
His height, 6 feet 7.
He weighs 285 pounds.
The size of Kodiak's ass. Hometown, Whitby, Ontario, Canada.
Stop looking down there, freak. Other ring named Martin Kane.
And he's best known as being intentionally stood up in the ring by Stephanie McMahon and being played like a fool by that bitch. And before that mess, Andrew got to start playing a bodyguard for the heavy metal band Motley Crue on an episode of Raw.
And how he broke into the WWF is a testament to Test. Get it? Testament, Test.
Very funny, Kodiak. Maybe you should trade your tights in for a stand-up routine.
Why don't you shut up?
Freak.
Well, the story goes like this. Andrew boldly went up to a group of WWF superstars who were hanging out at Toronto's Planet Hollywood after a show at the Sky Dome. He then tried to get into their private suite when he was stopped at the door by Carl DeMarco, president of WWF Canada.
And Andrew, figuring he was done for, was ready to run out the door when Carl surprised him by inviting then WWF superstar Bret Hart out to talk to him about getting into the world of wrestling. They hit it off so well that Bret decided to take Andrew under his wing and train him at the world-famous Hart Family Dungeon in Alberta, Canada. Don't get excited, Kodiak.
Shut up, you moron! Under Bret's supervision, Andrew wrestled in several small independent federations, even capturing the heavyweight title in Canada's hardcore Wild West wrestling circuit.
Within 2 months, Hart knew he had a star and tried to convince him to join the WCW, but Andrew had his heart set on the WWF.
Good move, Andrew. Why jump aboard the Titanic? I mean, the WCW? Come on. The WWF named Andrew Test, and the rest is wrestling history. Since his wedding debacle, Test is beginning some testicular fortitude and has become the hardcore champion. For a while, that is.
He's still a moron.
I bet he could beat your ass.
I'll take Test on any day of the week. You hear that, Test? You hear that? I'm calling you out. You hear that, you ponytail-wearing, bloody-nose sissy?
Take some breaths, Kodiak.
Breasts?
Breaths.
Oh, okay.
That's this week's edition of Unmasked.
Who's next?
How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Goldberg. And this crowd is on their feet.
Since our producer is a little slow... It's time for you to be the DJ. It's our Body Slam Song of the Week. If you want your song to be on Piledriver, it's just as easy as picking up your phone and dialing 1-877-792-SLAM. That's 1-877-792-SLAM.
And if we pick your Rudy Poo candy ass, you're getting a cool Piledriver t-shirt. So give us a big old hell yeah and call us at 1-877-792-SLAM.
Hey, Raz, do you have any more original sayings?
Hi, this is Rebecca from Princeton, New Jersey, and my Body Slam Song of the Week is Alice in Chains' Wood.
Piledriver.
When we come back from our intermission, we're going to kick it doggy style, urf, urf, for another hour. We've got our feature interview of the week with the king of hardcore, the legendary WWF superstar, Mick Foley.
If you bark like that again, I'm going to pile drive you.
I bet Mick Foley can kick your ass.
You know what, Raz? You can kiss my...
Beware of the midgets. They're taking over the world.
Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show. You're listening to Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show.
Hey, this is Raz, and we're back with more head slamming, chair busting, teeth rattling mayhem on Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show. Here's the fat ass.
That's right, here's the fat... Would you shut up, you moron? This is the Kodiak Bear. Back for hour number two, and if you thought the first one hurt, this one's gonna put you in the hospital. We got both the WCW and ECW updates, and I still have Roxy tied up on the ropes.
And we'll finish the Bone Crusher countdown, and our old school power bomb is around the corner. So let's start this biatch and kick the cheese whiz in the gear.
Cheese nits, you moron! Here's Freak with our feature interview of the week with the former WWF superstar, Mick Foley.
Thanks, Kodiak. It's Freak. On the phone with me is the one and only king of hardcore and best-selling author, one of my wrestling heroes, Mick Foley. How you doing, Mick?
Hey, it's nice to be on this show. I understand you guys have big plans now for rock and wrestling.
Did you think Stephanie McMahon could be such an evil bitch and play it so well?
I think I didn't know she could be such a hot wench. Hopefully Vince isn't listening to this. I think she was such a sweetheart. At one point, she was in a room with me, and I kept wondering, who is this person? And it wasn't until she said, "Hi, Mick, how you doing?" And I was like, "Hey, Stephanie?" Like, she just changed her look so much, and her whole way of dressing, and her whole personality seemed to change. So I think she's into it. I think she's enjoying herself.
You've started a trend. The Rock, Diamond Dallas Page, the WCW, and China, just to name a few, all have books out now or coming soon. How does it feel to be the leader of a literary revolution?
Actually, there were a few people a few years out of me. You know, Ted DiBiase put out a book, and Arn Anderson, a couple other guys, but they never had big publishers. So mine was the first one that was actually like a big event, and the literary world didn't think that wrestling fans would read. It's kind of ignorant. I mean, because wrestling fans are as intelligent as anybody, you know, as any group of people. And the truth is, most people don't read anything beyond magazines or newspapers. So what we did is we gave them something that they wanted to read about. So it felt good. It went to number one on the New York Times book list. So to lead the charge, felt pretty good. And I think if you look at my book, you know, it was a very personal thing. I wrote it myself, and it took a lot of time and effort. So it's very rewarding when people stop you and tell you that they love the book. So it felt good.
Later in the show, Mick talks about who's going to play him on the big screen and who was his toughest opponent ever. I know it wasn't you, Kodiak.
It might have been your sister, though.
Here's Godsmack with Voodoo.
Bone Crusher number 3.
I'm not too far away.
That was Godsmack with Voodoo, our number 3 Bone Crusher of the week.
He's got him in the corner.
Driver.
Now let's check back with Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com as he lets us know what's happening in the WCW.
The WCW Report.
This is Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com with your WCW Report. Who can save World Championship Wrestling from itself? Right now the company is at a crossroads, which has left many casual fans of WCW very confused. Under the Bischoff era that ended last October, you saw the NWO guys get the biggest pushes. Hogan, Nash, and Bischoff himself became Monday night staples that the majority of the broadcast would revolve around. Then came the short-lived Vince Russo era. Some were happy to see the deserving mid-card talents like Chris Benoit, Dean Malenko, Eddie Guerrero, and Conan suddenly get more airtime. But more were turned off by the resemblance of Nitro to the WWF product just a few channels over. Now in the Kevin Sullivan age, everything has become topsy-turvy. To the uninitiated fan unaware of backstage politics, it's very confusing to see Lex Luger back in the superhero light rather than the coward he portrayed just a few weeks ago. Or why the Total Package would team with Ric Flair after beating the Nature Boy with a bat and hurling insults at him alongside Sting in the recent past. I'm not arguing for one booking committee over another, but WCW has to find continuity if they hope to reclaim the top spot in the wrestling wars. For ScoopsWrestling.com, this is Al Isaacs with the WCW Report.
Thanks, Slapnuts. Hey, Freak's got more with WWF superstar Mick Foley. Freak?
So, who do you want to play Mick Foley, the movie version of Have a Nice Day?
Well, you know what? I intend to play myself, like the, 25 to 34 years, I think it'd be me. I don't know. It's crossed my mind. I'm wondering, all right, you need, like, a big star just to get people in there. Now, does a big star play, like, my dad or even, like, Dominic DiNucci? Does he have a big star playing him? Or do we get some young, hot guy, hot, nah, I don't mean hot in a sexual way. I mean hot as in hot commodity. Some up-and-coming superstar, is going to bring in some fans. I don't know. I think it definitely would make a good movie, and I know there's been some interest there.
In the book, you mentioned Vader, Terry Funk, and Undertaker, some of your toughest matches ever.
Right.
Who's the toughest opponent you ever have to face in the ring? If you just had to name one guy, who would be the toughest?
Yeah, probably Funk. I mean, on a lot of shows, I'll say Austin, just because, Steve's a, WWF, legend. But, I never did, like, the extreme things with Steve that I did with Funk, burning each other and landing on thumbtacks and all that type of thing.
Thanks, Freak. Later, Mick Foley tells us how he feels about the rise of his former federation, the ECW, and how he felt when a nurse threw his ear away after it was ripped off.
Oh, that was the grossest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Let's go! I've had many injuries in the ring. I've had boards cracked across my head. I've had chairs hit across my back.
You had your brains knocked out.
But getting my ear ripped off, now that's something I've never tried.
You should try it. All right, let's get on with the show.
Here's our old school powerbomb of the week, Motley Crue with Dr. Feelgood.
Old school powerbomb.
That did me good. What are you so antsy about over there?
Well, moron, if you didn't have your head so far up your ass, you'd know that Freak has been talking to the Monarch of Mayhem, the King of Hardcore. You know him as Mankind, Cactus Jack, and yes, even Dude Love. He's the one, the only, the former WWF superstar, Mick Foley. How can I not be Jack?
Since you did wrestle in the ECW, how do you feel about the ECW finally starting to take off as a federation?
I think that's great. I think it's great. I don't know how Paulie does it. They got a kind of small crew of guys. I think they're actually, I should watch their show more than I do, but I think they're actually focusing on some guys who can have good wrestling matches. They realize that the trend in WCW and WWF is towards shorter TV matches. So they got guys like a guy like Jerry Lynn is one of the best wrestlers in the entire business. And it gives him a chance to go out there for 15 minutes or so and put on a hell of a match. And then they also, they'll have their risque elements. And, since WWF kind of went in a wild direction, their show doesn't stand out as much for being, wild and woolly. But I think there's still that element of danger there.
I got to ask, after reading the book, did you want to punch the nurse who threw your ear away?
No, I wasn't angry. I was just, dumbfounded at the whole idea that she could just do that. It's like she knew I wanted the ear. Certainly, if they can transplant hearts and all those things, certainly they could have floated my ear in a jar of formaldehyde and had me bring it home with me.
After that, did you feel like, what the hell am I doing? I just lost my effing ear?
That's exactly what I said. The strange thing is at that time, even as I was going to bed, even after having the ear amputated, in my mind as I was going to sleep, I was like, we can turn this into a hell of a wrestling angle. And an angle, for those of you guys who don't know, that's, one of those events that propels matches, An angle would be, Mick Foley being fired, that type of thing. So I thought surely they'd create some great dramatic event around it. Now, unfortunately, I was working for WCW, a group of people that could screw up a wet dream. So they did absolutely nothing with that, Freak. I got to be honest with you. So it That was the real tragedy. Losing the year was not that bad. The tragedy is they didn't do anything with it.
Well, I just want to thank the legendary WWF superstar Mick Foley for taking some time out of his busy day to talk to us here at Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show. You can find Have a Nice Day, A Tale of Blood and Sweat Socks in bookstores everywhere. Thanks, Mick.
Hey, you have a nice day, too.
Geez, you think all the money Mankind is making off that book, he could buy a new phone.
Well, you know, he only has half an ear. He can't hear how bad that phone is.
Now, let's bite back.
Last week, we asked the fans, who do you think the hottest woman in wrestling is?
Hi, this is Bob Wooster Mass. I think the hottest chick in wrestling is Dawn Marie of the ECW. I mean, she shows her every time she gets in the ring.
This is Linda from Phoenix. The hottest woman in wrestling is Medusa of the WCW. If I had like that, I'd be showing them off every week, too.
This is Mitch from Philly. Kimberly Page is so hot, her Playboy spread made me blind in one eye.
Hey, this is Chuck from Bellingham, Washington. China, the WWF's ninth wonder of the world, is by far the hottest. I like a chick who will kick my ass before she nails me.
This is Alyssa from Scottsdale, Arizona. I think Stephanie McMahon of the WWF is the best-looking woman. I really like that slutty bad girl look.
What a bunch of hard-up, sick, perverted bastards! If you want to answer our Bite Back question of the week, just give us a call at 1-877-792-SLAM.
And if we use your bite, you'll get a head-pounded Piledriver t-shirt. We'll give next week's question later in the show. And after intermission, Roxy will be warm and waiting on the ropes.
And we'll check in with Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com for our ECW update.
This is Dawn Marie of ECW. And no matter what anyone says, I am cuter than Francine.
Oh, well, there's a news flash.
And you are listening to
Piledriver,
the Rock and Wrestling Radio Show.
You're listening to Piledriver, the Rock and Wrestling Radio Show.
We're back in the ring with our girl Roxy, still on the ropes and waiting. Let's check in with this hour's The Young and the Wrestlers.
And now, Roxy.
I'm back. Did you miss me? I missed you. Well, let's get started. In case you're just tuning in, I'm Roxy on the Ropes, and this is the place to hear all about the beautiful women of wrestling. We'll start with Kimberly Page, former head Nitro girl and the beautiful valet and real-life wife of WCW superstar Diamond Dallas Page. Did you know, besides her incredible figure, Kimberly is also a brain? That's right, both beautiful and brainy. Roxy's dazzled. Not only did she graduate magna cum laude with a BA in public relations and journalism, she also has a master's in advertising. Wow, most women in wrestling think magna cum laude is a porno movie. Well, you can see her mind as well as her body on Playboy.com and her own webpage with hubby Diamond Dallas Page on DDPBang.com. Did you ever dream of being a hoe? Well, maybe not, but you can still jump aboard the hoe train. All you have to do is send a revealing picture and a reason why you should be a hoe to hoe at WWF.com, and maybe, if you're lucky enough, the Godfather will put you on his website at WWFHoeTrain.com. Roxy would be so proud if one of her Piledriver listeners was a Godfather hoe. Well, my little honeys, until next week, I'll be in my ring on the ropes. This is Roxy for this week's The Young and the Wrestlers.
Thanks, Rox. We'll see you next week. Now let's get some fresh meat. This is where we focus on a new band we think is going to kick your teeth out in the future.
Now, this week's fresh meat.
Hailing from Des Moines, Iowa, Slipknot has built a solid fan base by putting on ear-crunching shows during Ozfest. There are 9 members of this touring lunatic asylum, and they always perform in masks.
Hey, everybody, what's up? It's number 6, the clown in the band Slipknot, for this week's fresh meat on Piledriver Rock and Wrestling Radio.
Hey, Raz, you said these guys wear masks, right?
Yeah.
You know what that guy needs? An oxygen mask! If that guy doesn't wake up, I'm gonna kick his Slipknotted ass!
You need a mask, you ugly thing. Here's Slipknot. That was Slipknot with Wait and Bleed from their self-titled CD, Our Fresh Meat of the Week.
Once again, here's Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com with what's going on with the true kings of hardcore, the ECW.
The ECW Report.
This is Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com with your ECW Report. Extreme Championship Wrestling finds itself in a very fortunate position, with neither the injury-plagued roster nor the high-end production costs of its big two counterparts. Paul E's organization is finally finding itself on the fast track to success. One only has to look at the record sales of their first video game, Hardcore Revolution, to realize that they've grown from a niche market to mainstream acceptance in the wrestling world. Unfortunately for them, however, the big two poster boys from the roster have been missing action as of late. First, Rob Van Dam, who's been sidelined with multiple fractures to his ankle. ECW has been very careful with the man who they consider to be their big franchise player, to the point that in a sign of good faith, they drew up a brand new 5-year contract extension with him just after they discovered the severity of his injury. It'll be another 2 months before he can get back into action, but at least fans can be assured that he will be at 100% when he does so. The other name is Sabu. Recently, WCW had announced they were in serious negotiations to bring him into their company, not realizing that the homicidal, genocidal one was pretty well locked into ECW for the next 5 years. Sabu has appeared at several ECW house shows, but you have to know that things must be tense backstage, knowing that Sabu had fully intended to jump ship. With your ECW report, this is Al Isaacs from ScoopsWrestling.com.
After our intermission, we go into the pit. That's where Razz, Freak, and I tell you what pisses us off and what we dig in wrestling this week.
And we'll give you the big three tour updates.
You want my head to explode?
Piledriver. We're back with more Piledriver.
It's time to get in the pit. This is the part of the show the federations don't want you to hear, and we tell you, the fans, uncensored, what's really ticking us off and what we like in the world of wrestling. Kodiak, start us off.
What I dislike is the whole angle with celebrities getting involved in wrestling. Back in the 70s, using Alex Karras was okay, and I could kind of live with Lawrence Taylor. But Dennis Rodman, the Jay Leno matches, and those dopes from Mad TV, that crap is way too much. This is my sport, and I expect it to have some dignity. Having non-wrestlers beat wrestlers does a disservice to the sport I love.
Oh, I'm very touched. How about you, Raz?
I bet your ballet dancers could beat some wrestlers.
Yeah, you're touching the head, Freak. And I'll ballet dance all over your face, Raz.
Cheerleaders could kick your ass.
What I am enjoying is the new WWF Tag Team Champions, the Dudley Boys. I know Bubba and Devon personally, and to be honest, I never, ever expected them to make the impact they are in the WWF. And that Bubba's craze look, that really gets to me. It kind of reminds me of the way Freak's girlfriend looked at me when she caught me dancing at the Go-Go-Rama. Priceless.
I think I'm going to be sick. The sight of Kodiak in a G-string makes me want to vomit.
It's an H-string.
Hit it, Freak.
What I'm not digging is the return of Hogan, or should I say the Hulkster, whatever he's calling himself these days. You know what? I was actually excited to see him come back, but now it's painful. Seeing an old balding guy who can barely lift his opponents is just not cool, especially in the days of The Rock, Triple H, and all the other high-octane talent. You know what, Hulk? It's time to pack it in and take Ric Flair with you. Pass the torch, please. All right, enough of that nonsense. What I am digging is ECW's impact players. Just incredible. Lance Storm, he had a goofball Jason. We'll throw him in there. And, of course, Dawn Marie.
Stop looking at my boobs.
You're dirty.
You pervert.
You know, when boobs are in my face, I'm going to look at them.
Got milk?
Can I get back to my segment?
Go ahead.
The Impact players are exciting to watch. They got the stuff.
Kodiak, stop showing her your boobs.
They got the stuff and they're hardcore. Plus, they have a cool catchphrase. Hit it, guys.
That's not just the coolest. That's not just the best. That's from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Now that's Justin. Incredible.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Did I mention Dawn Marie is quite the little?
Havana.
No, I'm thinking honey.
Do you two want to be alone?
Shut up. These guys are going far in the world of wrestling. Raz, take it away.
What's pissing me off this week is the complete lack of originality in the WCW. Is there anyone in the WCW that is creative? My left ass cheek is more creative.
I heard your right one was creative, too.
The WWF introduces two cool, two dancing idiots. For some reason, the crowd loves them. Then, magically, the WCW has three count. Three dancing idiots. This is such a ripoff. Does anybody think that Goldberg looks like Stone Cold?
I wonder.
I know a group of third graders who can write better plot lines.
Yeah, they write your jokes.
What I am digging is the WWF's light heavyweight champ, Enzo Rios, and his escort, Lita. I can't remember seeing a wrestler fly like this guy. and that Luca Libre is
Lucha
the most,
Libre.
Yeah, well, it's the most amazing style of wrestling I've ever seen, and I'm glad it's starting to make an impact. And to top it off, Lita can kick ass and fly around as well as he can.
She's a hot piece of flying ass.
What's wrong with you two morons?
Hey, we recognize good ass.
Now look at this.
Kodiak, pull your pants up. We'll be back in the pit next week. Enough talking and more ass-kicking tunes.
Bone Crusher number 2.
This is Angus Young.
And Brian Johnson of ACDC.
And here's our latest song from Stiff Upper Lip on
Piledriver, the rock and wrestling radio show. Will I?
Piledriver.
That was our number 2 Bone Crusher, AC/DC. Let's hit the road and go on tour.
All right, Razz, let's find out where and when the big three will be in your area.
The WWF in March. Raw is War in East Rutherford, New Jersey on March 13th. On the 14th, it's SmackDown in Uniondale, Long Island, New York. On March 18th, Cedar Falls City, Iowa on the campus of UNI. On the 19th, it's in Moline, Illinois. On the 20th, Raw is War in Chicago. On the 21st, SmackDown is in Milwaukee. On March 22nd, Champaign, Illinois. On March 27th, Raw is War comes to Houston. And on March 28th, SmackDown is in San Antonio.
The ECW, they'll be in Worcester, Mass. On the 17th of March. That's WAAF territory. Salem, New Hampshire, March 18th. Wichita, Kansas, March 24th. Kansas City, Kansas, March 25th. March 31st, Richmond, Virginia.
WCW comes slamming in March on the 13th. Monday, Nitro in Providence, Rhode Island. Thunder tapings, Fairfax, Virginia on the 15th. Saturday, TV tapings in Salem, Virginia. On March 19th, Uncensored Pay-Per-View in Miami, Florida. On the 20th, Monday Nitro in Gainesville, Florida. On the 21st, Thunder Tapings, Orlando, Florida. On March 25th, Abilene, Texas. On March 26th, Waco, Texas. On March 27th, Monday Nitro at South Padre Island, Texas. On the 28th, Thunder Tapings in Houston, Texas. The 29th, Saturday TV Tapings in Beaumont, Texas. On the 30th, Baltimore, Maryland. And on the 31st, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
When we come back to the ring, we've got our number one Bone Crusher and our bite back question for next week.
Hi, this is Mary Mary from Apollo 440, and we cannot stop The Rock, and neither can you. You are listening to Piledriver, The Rock and Wrestling Radio Show.
This is The Rock, the People's Champ of the WWF, and The Rock says you're listening to Piledriver, The Rock and Wrestling Radio Show, if you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Piledriver. You're listening to Piledriver, The Rock and Wrestling Radio Show.
We're dealing with sick people here.
This week, our bite back question of the week is, who do you think is the king of hardcore?
Ron Jeremy!
Call us at 1-877-792-SLAM.
877-792-SLAM. So if you punks want a kick-ass Piledriver t-shirt, you better call. Get ready. Here's our hardest rocking song of the week.
Bone Crusher number 1.
Red Hot Chili Peppers, Other Side, our number 1 Bone Crusher.
Yeehaw! It's a good show.
That does it for this week's edition of Piledriver, the Rock and Wrestling Radio Show. We'll be back next week with more hell-raising, chair-busting, teeth-rattling action. And our feature interview next week will be WCW superstar Diamond Dallas Page, plus Roxy, Freak, and the rest of the Misfits. We'll be back.
For daily updates on your favorite wrestling action in and out of the ring, check out ScoopsWrestling.com. This is the Kodiak Bear.
And this is Razz. Keep it in the ring.
Wrestling's fake. Wrestling's not fake!
The executive producer of Piledriver is Joshua Feigenbaum.
Thanks for the paycheck, boss man.
Senior producer Phil Rado.
Isn't that Clay used to play with as a kid?
Written and produced by Corey Natko.
What a moron.
Engineered by Rafael Jimenez.
That's Jimenez, you moron!
Production assistance by John Weber, Michael Azer, Diane Tonelli, Dwayne Crawford, TJ Abdullah,
The Butcher,
and Vinny Mico. Piledriver is an exclusive presentation to the MJI Radio Network, copyright 2000, all rights reserved. No portion may be used without the written permission of the producers.
Okay, so thanks for listening there, you screwball bastard.
Piledriver is not affiliated with the WWF, WCW, ECW, or any wrestling federation or publication. We're nobody's bitch.